And to be perfectly honest with you, there were times that I definitely wanted to pack up and leave Paris. It's not like what you see on your Pinterest board. It's not what you see on Instagram at all. There are definitely hard times and definitely things about the city that I don't really like at all, if I'm being completely honest. Hey everyone, it's me, Edwina, back with another video. I wanted to talk about today some things that I hate and love about my au pair year in Paris. And I wanted to do this particularly at this time because I feel like this is rematch period of people just becoming au pairs and realizing the realities of what that really means. And I wanted to just let you know that you're not alone. Like, it's a hard thing to go through, and what you're experiencing is completely normal. There are good and bad sides. And so I wanted to just highlight both of those sides to give you an idea of what you have to look forward to and like kind of how to overcome it if you're going through challenges. So with that said, here are a few things of what I hate and what I love about my au pair year in Paris. The first thing that I love, to start out on a good note, is the aesthetic of the city. I really did move to Paris, like, if I'm being 100% honest, because of what it looks like on Instagram. Or we didn't even have Instagram very much when I moved there, which is insane to say because it feels like Instagram has been around forever. But it was really about the aesthetic of it, what I saw in movies and pictures and Pinterest. I loved it, and I moved without even knowing about the city, and that still sticks with me today. Like, I love walking around Paris, just like looking at the buildings, looking at the sky, the doors, the windows, the cafes, on and on and on. I can go on and on. I particularly like the bridges, which is actually what kind of brought me to where I live right now in Portland, Oregon, because even though Portland is such an industrial city, it does have these several bridges that cross the Columbia River. And so that was just something that reminded me of Paris, because every bridge is so unique, and it's the same thing for Portland. So it's just kind of like my little piece of Paris here in Portland. I also just love the city and just looking at it. It's something that I've learned that I really want to see in the future cities that I live in. I really look for like pretty cities, as like shallow and superficial as that is. I really just like to live in a pretty place. And that definition of beauty is really different for me, like kind of concrete jungle sometimes. And that's just me. Second positive, to start off with more positives, is the size of the city. I love Paris's size because there's the périphérique, which is the line around Paris. It contains the city to be only so big, which I really, really like, because it doesn't feel so huge and overwhelming. For me, London feels really big, New York feels really, really big. It's like almost overwhelming how large it is. And Paris, it feels like it's very centralized. Everyone goes to the same part of the city, and then they might live more on the outskirts of the city. But I only lived in Paris for like 6 years on and off. Really, like, if I'm being honest, maybe 4 years straight through. And I pass people all the time in the street, and I just feel that that brings that sense of home to me. So I go to look, now that I'm like moving around and things, I look for cities that are the same kind of medium size. And that's honestly flexible because Paris extends into the suburbs and things, but the way that it's constructed is very centralized, and I just love that because it makes me feel like I can live in a city but still construct this idea of home and meeting a lot of people and having that like almost campus university feel where you're all going to the quad and then coming back. Like, I can construct that very, very fast. Whereas in a city like London, I feel like that takes more of an effort to establish your community, to establish your sense of home in the city, and to get to know a lot more people. Number three that I loved about living in Paris was just living in a different country, culture, and world. I love being able to speak French every day. It's something that I really, really miss living in the States right now. That said, I do have people that I speak French with, but I do miss just like forcing myself to speak French every day and so consistently. And it's just like a cool exercise for your brain that I had on the daily basis that I don't have anymore. And it's something that I always miss when I'm not in Paris. So if you're an au pair right now and you're just learning your new language, whether it's French or another language, like, really don't take that for granted. It's a really good exercise for your brain, and it's only temporary, and it's totally hard, and there's totally culture shocks and things of that nature, but it's really cool. And when you leave it, you kind of miss it sometimes. So yeah, third thing that I miss is the language. All right, time for some negatives. We've talked on this channel before about negatives, both about London and about Paris, but I kind of want to talk about more negatives, specifically about au pairing and how there are certain aspects of your au pair life that is just are not that fun. And so when I first moved to Paris, obviously I was an au pair, and the first thing that I really just had a hard time with that I didn't know was a thing was that there's a lot of loneliness and meeting people when you move to a new city, whether that's as an au pair or as an adult, is something that you have to put so much effort into. And it wasn't until the end of my au pair year that I really started to feel like I was meeting and crossing paths with people that I knew. And that was because I like went out, made my own community, made my own Facebook group, and sought out that community. But that said, like, I had a winter where I was very, very, very isolated and alone. And that was definitely hard for my mental health and something that is natural. It happens when you move to a new city. I like now expect that period. And it just takes time. And that's what really sucks. And I've said it a lot on this channel, but it's true. It takes time and effort and energy. And there's a lot of loneliness attached to it. But if you want it, stick with it. You're not alone. It's just part of the game, really. And it's not just au pairing. It's just moving as an adult in general. Number two, a second thing that I didn't love about being an au pair was living with my host family. I had a few different host families during my au pair year, and sometimes this can go really well. When I was a student and studied abroad, I lived with a host family who I freaking loved, got along with so well, felt like I could be my whole self with them. But with my host family as an au pair, I didn't quite feel that way. I lived separately for some of the time, but with another experience, I did live with my host family, and that was difficult because you just have to put a lot of effort into sharing your space, how you're going to behave in certain spaces, and you honestly have to take your filter off and make that choice to be yourself in their space, which is not an easy task. We've given advice in different videos about that before, which we'll link down below or here maybe if I remember. It is something that is a part of the au pair program, and living with your family, you're kind of always on, it's not that you're always on call because you really should have a good schedule of when you're working and when you're not. And you know, some families are better than others at doing that. But just living with a family in general, like, you have to be aware of their schedule. Sometimes with some host families, you can feel like they are your parents, which is annoying if you're like, you know, an 18 to 25 year old as an au pair, and just being kind of watched, even if they're not watching you, and they're the nice people in the world. They know what you're doing, and for someone who lived alone or was in college before that, that can be pretty hard. And the third negative thing about being an au pair and my au pair year in Paris was money. Living in a big city made it really, really difficult to budget because I wanted to do so much. That said, museums were free, which was really cool. A lot of things were free for students and for people under 26. France is really, really great about that, which is awesome. But I did have to budget very, very diligently, and if anything, it prepared me for real life, and now I'm a great budgeter and I'm super frugal. But the minimum au pair salary is 80 euros a week in France, and if you're living in a big city, it's all the more harder. I mean, you know, you have to be drinking espresso and not your lattes, which I got used to drinking and then quickly switched back once I moved out of Paris or had a bigger budget. But it was all worth it. That's why it's so much better when you make other au pair friends, because they understand your lifestyle, they understand that you're broke because they're broke too, and then you can do fun broke things together. Like Hannah and I would just go for really long walks and not spend a single dime all day because we were both super frugal. And honestly, that deepened our friendship, and that's probably why we became so close so fast, was because we were having the same struggles and sharing the same struggles. But yeah, money was a big issue, if I'm being honest, and it was not easy, but it was still worth it. Like, I would not trade my experience for the world. I just wish that I had known to come into my au pair year with like a little more savings so that I could travel and see more of Europe and not worry so much about that topic. It makes your life so much easier. I mean, you can see the video of Atavia moving back to France. She had come with savings, and it really saved her in the long run, especially if you're thinking about rematch with a family. Like, having that cushion of money to save you so that you can decide to stay in a hotel or something, worst case scenario. I'm not saying this is like what happens or that this is even a necessity, but just having that financial security in the back of your head changes your perspective and changes your approach, how you approach your year and traveling and everything. So something that I wish I knew and that I didn't have. All that to say, I hope this video helped you kind of decipher some real challenges that I went through and some real things that I miss about Paris that you should not take for granted if you were there or in France in general. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments down below. And if you like this video and want us to make more like this, definitely give it a thumbs up. That's how we know that you liked it. Give us a comment and we will make more. And that is all for now. I hope you're having a great day and I will see you in the next video. Ciao! Woo!